Our today's class focuses on mobile IP technique. Mobile networking is becoming increasingly important as portable devices, as such as smartphones, are becoming so prevalent. The link between the portable device and the fixed communication network is usually wireless. The problem is, IP address specifies point of attachment to the internet, and changing IP address at runtime involves terminating all connections and sections. Here we look at a simple mobile IP solution, where devices can change point of attachment while retaining IP address and maintaining communications. This figure illustrates routing in mobile IP that allows portable devices called mobile hosts to roam from one area to another while maintaining the communication sessions. One requirement in mobile IP is that a mobile host must continuously use its permanent IP address even as it roams to another area. Otherwise, existing sessions will stop working and new sessions should be started when a mobile host moves to another area. A host agent keeps track of location of each mobile host in its network. Home agent periodically announces its presence. It manages all mobile hosts in its home network that use the same address prefix. If a mobile host is in the home network, for example, mobile host number 1, home agent forwards packets directly to the mobile host. When a mobile host moves to a foreign network, for example, mobile host number 2, the mobile host obtains a care of address from the foreign agent and registers this new address with its home agent. The mobile IP routing operates as follows. When a correspondent host wants to send a packet to a mobile host, it transmits the standard IP packet with its address as the source IP and the mobile host addresses as the destination IP. This is illustrated as step 1 in the figure. This packet will be intercepted by the mobile host home agent. If the mobile host is located in the foreign network, the home agent simply forwards the packet to its foreign agent. This is illustrated as step 2. The foreign agent forwards the packet to the mobile host, and the mobile host sends packets to the correspondent host as usual, as illustrated as the step 3. The question is, how does a home agent send packets to the mobile host in a foreign network? The problem is solved by providing a tunnel between the home agent and the foreign agent, and implemented by encapsulating each IP packet at the home agent with an outer IP address containing the home agent address as a source IP address and care of address as a destination IP address. When the foreign agent receives the packet, the foreign agent decapsulates the packet that produced the original IP packet with the corresponding host address as a source IP address and the mobile host address as a destination address. The foreign agent can then deliver the packet to the mobile host. Packets transmitted by the mobile host to the correspondent host typically use a normal IP packet format, with a mobile host address as a source IP address and the correspondent host address as destination IP address. These packets follow the default route. We can observe that the route traveled by the packet from the correspondent host to the mobile host is typically longer than that from the mobile host to the correspondent host. Several proposals exist to improve this routing mechanism so that the correspondent host may send packets directly to the care of address endpoint in subsequent exchanges. One solution is illustrated here. When the home agent receives a packet from a correspondent host destined to a mobile host, as illustrated by step one, it tunnels the packet to the current care of address as before, as illustrated by step 2a. However, it also sends a binding message back to the correspondent host containing the current care of address, as illustrated by step 2b. The correspondent host can save this information in its binding cache so that a future packet to the mobile host can be directly tunneled to the care of address, as illustrated by step 4. This concludes our lesson on mobile IP.